Okay. It seems like the investors are quite interested in this whole, Sense Chat, Sense Nova. What was this event like, Peter?
Yeah, it was interesting. We've had a few companies follow in the footsteps of OpenAI and come out with AI services. Other Chinese companies have done this already, too. SenseTime is not as high profile as some of the others, including Alibaba and Baidu, but they had a pretty impressive demonstration of these new AI services. The CEO, Xu Li, took the stage and showed off a suite of services. As you mentioned, the centerpiece was this rival to ChatGPT. It's called SenseChat. And he showed how you could ask questions and get answers from the chatbot to do things like tell stories. There was a story about a cat catching fish, for example. But more practically, there were also applications where you could use this chatbot in order to do computer programming. He demonstrated English and Chinese also. That was sort of the centerpiece, but there were other things too, including one for 3D modeling for architecture, for example, another one that could be used to drop images into video. So overall, it was pretty impressive. Shares are up quite strongly this morning.
Yeah, and maybe, Peter, if you could remind some of our viewers who might not sort of be as familiar where the pieces really fit here. How does SenseTime, or where does SenseTime actually fit into China's tech industry at this point?
Sure. So SenseTime is really best known for its facial recognition software. It helps with these cameras that you see all over China. It's been controversial for that reason. It's gotten in trouble with the U.S. government in particular. Again, it's not as high profile as some of the giants in the tech space in China, like an Alibaba or a Tencent or a Baidu, but it has really developed this expertise in facial recognition. And more broadly, it made the case that it has access to tons of data to be able to train these large language models, its AI services more broadly. It also has the kind of deep computing power that you need to be able to develop these services. So it had a pretty forceful demonstration yesterday. Alibaba is going to demonstrate their AI services just today. So we're going to see what the competitive landscape looks like in China very shortly here.